Ciudad del Carmen, a boomtown on the Gulf of Mexico with large offshore oil fields. The rich petroleum resources have changed the lives of the people here. About 30 miles outside Ciudad del Carmen, elaborate excavation work was getting underway. In no time at all, a huge construction site came into being. A plant was under construction here to produce 40,000 tons of nitrogen per day and pump it through a pipeline over 60 miles long to the offshore oil fields to improve extraction efficiency. The Cantarell project, with its four identical air separation units, was the largest air separation complex in the world. It was built by Linde for an international operator consortium and represents a milestone in the history of plant construction. In the Munich headquarters, developing and planning work was running full speed ahead. With an assembly time of only 9 months, there was no margin for error. Klaus Poganski, the project manager in charge of delivering the project at top quality, on schedule.
Linde has the world's largest production capacity for aluminum heat exchangers. Without it, we'd never be able to supply 23 exchangers per unit, a total of 92 in such a short time. The columns and condensers are the cold box equipment, and they too come from Germany. Because of scheduling and quality requirements, we produce them at Linde's plant in Schalchen.
After the production hurdles were surmounted, there was an equally tough problem to solve: finding a logistically feasible way for getting this bulky heavyweight cargo from Schalchen to Mexico. Klaus Platz, the head of Linde's shipping department.
We're the people who make sure the shipments get to their destination on the contractually stipulated delivery date. It was our job to develop a practicable transport concept to move the four big units to Mexico.
A concept that would have to take into account both the huge distance of almost 7,500 miles over the widest variety of transport routes and obstacles. Here too, speed is one of the crucial factors. Helmut Lersch, who was in charge of carrying out the transportation scheme, tells us.
The first stage went from Schalchen to Passau. The size and weight of the cargo presented a logistical problem. We first had to set the route.
Any unexpected obstacle could endanger the transport project. Escort vehicles kept the road clear. Bridges, signal units, and electric poles could not be allowed to impede progress. Even so, the convoy needed 2 days to cover the short 100-mile distance from Schalchen to Passau.
The second stage of the trip to Mexico started in Passau when the cargo was loaded by mobile cranes into the ship's hold.
The MS Europa and her heavy cargo were en route for 11 days from Passau to a German North Sea port. Bremen, an international hub for seagoing cargo. Here, on a shop floor directly adjoining the loading dock, the 8 gigantic heat exchanger boxes, also called hex boxes, were put together for Cantarell. They are the largest individual pieces to be transported to the construction site in Mexico. Klaus Poganski explains why they were nevertheless assembled in Germany.
We prefabricated the hex box modules to realize the very short 9-month assembly time. We made inquiries for the prefabrication process in Germany, England, and America. The Germans made us the most inexpensive offer. That meant we also had to budget the very high transport costs. The special problem here involved both transporting the huge boxes from Bremen to the construction site, as well as delivering the absorbers which came from Korea.
The two boxes tipped the scales at a total of over 380 metric tons. This meant every loading procedure represented a challenge to both the crew and their machines.
We needed a specific time window for this transport. That means we had to start preparations several months before the actual shipment. We had to book shipboard space on time so that a ship would actually be available for the delivery date. Then the ships needed to be equipped to handle these enormous heavy units. These vessels have their own loading cranes, both for loading and unloading the cargo.
Loading the jumbo ship called for fingertip sensitivity and plenty of experience on the part of the Dutch captain and his crew, because the ship would have to be kept precisely in balance throughout the entire loading procedure. This was done by pumping ballast water in and out. Linde commissioned the Dacotrans company in Düsseldorf to handle the overseas shipment to Mexico. In Mexico, the Cotrans company in Mexico City took over.
The third stage of the trip began in Bremen. 21 days were allotted for the seaboard journey to Coatzacoalcos in Mexico. Heavy storms at sea forced the ship to make a detour that cost us a two-day delay.
Linde is responsible for supplying everything, worldwide, at the best conditions. This meant that in addition to these large-scale shipments, a total of 12,000 freight tons of bulk material had to be acquired and shipped more than 100,000 miles to Mexico from all over the world. Coatzacoalcos in the Mexican state of Tabasco. After 23 days, sometimes over heavy seas through a hurricane, the Stella Nova reached this seaport, the closest one to the Cantarell construction site. The valuable cargo did not slip one inch throughout the entire journey. The modules had to be loaded aboard high sea barges to bring them closer to the site. This transfer procedure also called for plenty of skill and experience on the part of the Cape Verdean crew, and seamless communication and cooperation with the Germans and the Dutch, as well as the Mexican stevedores and barge crews. Because there weren't any barges in all of Mexico large enough for the job, the available ones first had to be cut in pieces and then welded back together to make carrier barges the size of soccer fields. The truck trailers were then welded to these barges so the heavy cargo could immediately be placed on its final transport vehicles. The project manager and the captain had every reason to be satisfied.
In Mexico, we got a specialist with years of experience in transporting industrial units in this country.
From Coatzacoalcos, the journey proceeded some 150 miles to the mouth of the Rio San Pedro, a not completely risk-free journey because the famous Norte, a downland wind, can cause sizable delays.
Another obstacle was a sandbank near the river that our barges and high-sea tugboats couldn't sail through.
Out of consideration for the fisherfolk who live here, Linde decided not to excavate the sandbank. To get the barges to their landing position anyway, a virtual armada of small vessels was recruited from the area to pull the unusual cargo into the mouth of the river. As it is impossible for the large vessels to land upstream in the fishing village of Nuevo Campechito, a jetty first had to be constructed to bring the large units directly onto the road in a roll-off procedure. Another destination was reached. The project and transport managers were, as always, right there. An unpleasant surprise was waiting for the transport team the following morning. The barge with the lower hex box module got stuck overnight on an uncharted sandbank and would not be able to get herself free under her own power. A line was extended from the barge to the land and attached to one of the heavy-duty tractors. Both the line and everybody's nerves were stretched to the breaking point. Finally, relief. The plan worked. With combined power, the barge was pulled into deeper water so that a little later these two boxes could also roll off onto the road.
On the last stage, about 16 miles to the construction site, thoroughgoing measures were again taken to get things moving ahead.
Here, as in Europe, elaborate preparations had to be made. All the electrical poles had to be moved back some 4 yards on both sides of the road. A custom shack was half dismantled. The road shoulders were reinforced, and then everything had to be returned to its previous condition afterwards. Suddenly the weather changed. Darkness came early on this important day, so that the convoy couldn't make it all the way to the site. The two precious boxes had to be kept overnight on a free stretch of road. Nobody was very enthusiastic at the end of this strenuous day. Every delay was promptly registered by the shipping management in Munich.
We were able to get an overview of the delivery situation from a program we developed in-house. It was able to locate every item at any point in time.
Early the next morning, the shipment started on its last short trip to the construction site, where the people were already waiting for it. Everyone was happy the important sections had arrived undamaged and right on schedule.
For all the difficulties involved, we still managed to make delivery right on time.
Another milestone in the Cantarell project had been reached. The boxes, columns, and condensers for the 4 air separation units could be erected on time, on site, to the satisfaction of everyone involved in the construction job.